game I played as a child, Men of Valor. I seen it on Steam, and I was way too excited. I had to pick it up. This is probably one of the first semi-realistic games I played. I grew up playing Call of Duty and Desert Storm, things like that. When I played this, just the simple fact of when you got shot, you kept bleeding until you bandaged was something that just I had to pick up again and check it out. I hope you guys enjoy. This is literally the first time I've even considered playing it since I played it as a child, so this is a first look for me kind of again. I haven't touched the controls. I've just basically set up my graphic settings. That's it. I'm going to go straight into it and see what it's like. This is a ridiculously old game. It's on the Unreal Engine 2.0.
After years of sending advisors, supplies, and military assets to combat insurgency in South Vietnam, the United States decides to commit ground troops to guard its bases and personnel from rising guerrilla activity. In March of 1965, the 9th Marine Expeditionary Force comes ashore at Da Nang to provide protection to the airfield and vital port. Greeted with enthusiasm by the local population, the Marines hope their presence will deter Viet Cong activity in the vicinity of Da Nang.
Propaganda much?
But this is not to be. As guerrilla activity intensifies, American military personnel become favored targets. Within a month, President Johnson authorizes the Marines to begin offensive combat operations around Da Nang. At first, these operations are small in scale, aimed at locating the Viet Cong and preempting their attacks. Most engagements are intense, but over quickly, as the Viet Cong disperse before the superior firepower of American forces. These actions result in much higher casualties for the Viet Cong than for the Americans they attack, prompting many observers to suggest that the conflict in Vietnam will be a very short one.
Oh my God, those graphics.
Have you seen any action yet?
Action? Hell, 2 days ago I got my ass bitten off by fire ants. Other than that, no. Been working on my suntan. This country is beautiful though, ain't it?
It sure is. Okay, Don, I think that's all. Thanks, soldier. Fire ants. Jesus.
Exciting stuff, Morris.
Don, let me get a sign-off here.
Mouse acceleration.
This is Morris Schiffer reporting from the Da Nang Air Base, Vietnam, with the Marines of the 3rd Battalion.
Let me just edit that. Can I edit masses? Oh, there.
Yo, Chef! Pick up that football! It's under the truck!
What truck? Right.
Oh. Throw it here, man!
Yeah!
Nice toss! Great job!
Yeah!
Up. Heads up!
Horse! Go along!
Shoot, I'm a defensive tackle, man. Keep that thing away from me.
What is he doing?
Shepard!
Yeah!
Oh, oh, God! Did you get that?
Yeah. Oh, did you see that?
Oh, Christ!
Just play football.
Get your asses in gear!
I want you men to grab your gear and get back here in 15. Victor Charlie is launching those rockets.
We need really in a circle with mortars going off.
They'll be around when we get out there, but we'll take a few patrols out there just in case. Dismissed.
Dear Mom, I'm still safe and sound. None of us have seen any real action, although the lieutenant says we're due to head on a patrol sometime soon. Spend most of our time drilling or just throwing the football around. Reminds me of two-a-day football practices back in high school. Us Black Marines mostly stick to ourselves and don't get bothered much. Lawrence Styles, the guy we call Smooth, got in a shoving match with some white guys about butting in line at the mess. But he's from Detroit and has a chip on his shoulder. I did make friends with a big white farm boy from Iowa who everybody calls Hoss. And he keeps most of the crackers off our backs. It's been a smooth couple of weeks. The base gets mortar and rocket fire almost nightly, but no one in my unit's been hurt. And we're almost getting used to it, if you can believe that. The locals are pretty nice to us. And although some of the guys say the villagers are the same ones shooting rockets at us, I have a hard time believing it. It's been dry for a month. Dirt's pretty red. Reminds me a lot of Oklahoma in the summer. I'll write you again as soon as anything happens. I hope you and Dad and Jamie are all right. Think about you all the time. Your son, Dean.
All right.
Hoss, you must have pissed someone off. Either that, or you're dumber than I thought.
Well, how you figure?
White boy like yourself getting stuck going out in the bush with a bunch of brothers.
Ain't you heard, Smooth? Charlie don't like to fire black folk. The way I see it, I stay close to you. I go home on a freedom bird and not in a body bag.
Holy shit, that's just racist as shit.
That noise. Charlie does not discriminate. Still, we keep pulling jobs like this one. We should get out of the NAM with no more than a scratch.
Then why the hell are we riding up top instead of inside the APC?
This tin can hits a booby trap on the road. You don't want to be inside. Shrapnel bounces around in there like a rubber ball.
But up here we sitting ducks for an ambush.
There ain't gonna be no ambush. Lieutenant Trazek says Charlie got out of here weeks ago. They pop in and shoot a rocket at the base and then leave. The grunts have been running patrols through here for the last
shit.
We gotta get going.
What?
Move that bull, man. We got places to go.
Hey, Hoss, you got experience with them farm animals. Why don't you get out and milk that thing or something?
Very funny, Greaser. Very funny.
Move that goddamn bull, Mama-san!
Yeah. Oh god,
get some cover
outside.
On this side of the APCs. Watch for sniper fire.
I'm looking.
Crater. Sucker is probably a 400 pounder. Good Christ. Should we call for a medevac?
For that red spot over there? Shit, man. Anybody got an E-tool?
Show some fucking respect, asshole! That could be any one of us over there!
Sorry, sir.
You see anything, Tony?
Negative. Wait, hold on a second.
Snipers along the tree line! Contact! Gooners on the tree line! This is what they pay us for, Marines! Move up to cover, come on!
I can't believe this, man! Contact! Shit!
Okay.
Smooth, you forget how to use that rifle? Damn it, put out rounds!
Kiss my black ass, farm boy. This M14 don't buy as fast as your 60.
Oh, you want to trade?
Will you push that the hell up? Shit! It's tighten up time. We're going in there after them. They may be setting up an ambush, or they may have already skied out. Peep the trails for booby traps. Keep an eye on your team and fire discreet bursts. Let's move out.
following people into the jungle, it always seems like a good idea.
If they hit us, it'll be most rickety-tick. Keep your eyes open.
Get some cover!
What are we doing here? Magazine?
Go!
Get the hell out of the way. Let's see if we can make the HUD smaller. I believe we can. Find an AK-47. Ooh, what was that? Ooh, even better.
Another trap! Watch your asses!
Oh, no. Oh, the fucking... How many guns can he carry? A lot, apparently. Oh, there's a trap. Can I disarm it? No.
Up that hill. Looks like we might have hit pay dirt today. Let's take out those spider holes.
A lot of acceleration or weird graphical shit.
Come on! Put on rounds! I got some more!
Looks like Charlie's dug in on the top of that hill. Shepard, I could call for some arty if you get close enough to get those coordinates.
Shep, get on up there and get those cords.
Wait. Really close to dying. Oh, this is not good. That is not fair. So dead.
Dear Mr. and Mrs. Roland Shepard, this is one of the most difficult letters I have been required to write. It is with the most heartfelt sympathy that I, as his commanding officer, write to you of the death of your son, Private First Class Dean Shepard, ASN 989-31357, at 1:30 on the afternoon of 14 April, 1965. Dean was killed in action by enemy fire while in the performance of his duty. While on patrol to locate rocket sites west of Da Nang, his unit was ambushed by snipers. In the ensuing firefight, Dean was struck by multiple enemy rounds and died before he could receive medical attention. The loss of your son, who was affectionately known by everyone in the company as the Shepherd, is felt by every member of this command. He was a fine soldier and a natural leader, and he always put his comrades ahead of himself.
Is there a save? Yeah.
It looks like Charlie's dug in on the top of that hill. Shepard, I can call for some arty if you get close enough to get those coordinates.
Shep! Get on up there and get those coordinates!
What the hell did he shoot me with? There it goes. Okay.
God damn, look at that!
They must have been using that dirt ramp to launch rockets at the base. Genius bastards.
Slick-ass muggles. How'd he get that rocket up here?
Get some cover and fire all the tree line! Six, we need some napalm on a tree line. Ship fire Niagara, 100 meters. Fire for effect, over. We got a fast mover on deck with some napalm. Lay chilly and watch your flanks.
I think they're pissed off.
Dear Dad, you told me I would see things over here that I'd never want to know about. Well, we finally got sent out on patrol, looking for VC who was shooting rockets at the base. We were rolling along on top of the APCs when some locals shoved a water buffalo out in front of us. I thought they were just some farmers with a stubborn animal. But when one of the guys got down to help him out, he stepped on some kind of landmine. Then the shooting started and I knew we'd been ambushed. Lieutenant Tracek, the one we call Zook, got the rest of us through okay, and we managed to chase off the VC, but we were all scared as hell. Except for the guy, I don't even know his name, who stepped on that booby trap. Dad, I don't think there was a piece left of him bigger than my fist. We're all Marines here.
Dear Mom and Dad, sorry I haven't written in a while, but things are a little hectic over here. The local guerrillas have been attacking more frequently. They haven't been doing a lot of damage, but they do keep everyone on edge. Fortunately, we think we know where they're staging from. There's a small village to the southwest of Da Nang that seems to be the focus of their activity. We're heading out to search the hamlet and drive out any Viet Cong we find. It shouldn't be too dangerous. We'll be riding in armored personnel carriers, and the VC usually just run when they show up. Zook will be leading us out again. We're also taking along the reporter, Morris Schiffer, from the network news. I don't think they'd let him come if it was gonna be really dangerous. Hey, maybe you'll see me on TV. Oh, forgot to tell you guys something last letter. Pat Hodges from Tulsa will be joining the squad in a few weeks. He was our fullback on the football team. The Marines are actually teaching him Vietnamese. Can you believe that? Anyway, don't worry too much about me and tell Jamie to stay out of trouble. Love, Dean.
My last time out with Zook, I greased 10 gunas all by myself. Real number 10 shit, man. Poor pastors never even knew what hit him. Pop, 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 pop. Tin cans lined up on a wall.
Yeah, you a bad motherfucker, all right. Ain't he bad, Hoss?
Yeah, he's bad, all right. Wonder if this tin can's gonna get us close to the Ville.
We're grounded. Looks like you boys gotta get out and hump it from here. The other APCs are grounded too.
Not close enough, I guess.
Shit! You guys waiting for a formal invitation?
Move! Jungle Rock tearing my feet up. I can't hardly walk. Sniper,
let's rock
take
and roll!
Behind the APC!
Yes.
Yeah! Shepard, stay near the APC, man. There's snipers everywhere!
Nope. dick. I see you sneaking on that bridge.
Change of plans. Without the APCs, we don't have a direct route through the jungle. We're gonna have to take a slight detour to get to the ville. Let's move it! Get down to that creek bed!
Aye.
Alright, I want you three to take point. Move down this creek bed a few clicks. There should be a path somewhere along the creek bed that leads north into the jungle. We'll bring up the rear.
Hey, wait a minute. We're going with the on-point squad.
Someone give you a field promotion? I'm in charge here. Your ass is staying with me. I was given specific orders to babysit both your butts.
Yeah, you guys make sure you get some good footage, you hear?
Hey, can it, asshole!
Hey, Hoss, I bet you're used to stomping around waist-deep in shit, ain't you? Probably reminds your ass of home, don't it?
Shit, Charlie, 12 o'clock! Greaser, why didn't you light him up?
What if it's just a villager?
Yeah, right, just a villager.
Again! No way to quit!
Hey, Grease, Dean's here, folks.
Yes, Charles!
Okay. That screwed me.
Dear Mr. and Mrs. Roland Shepard.
Hey, Hoss, I bet you're used to stomping around waist deep in shit, ain't you? Probably reminds your ass of home, don't it?
Shit, Charlie, 12 o'clock. Greaser, why did you light him up?
What if it's just a village?
Yeah, right, just a village. Hey, Greaser, these here folks just villagers?
Looks like they're pinned down. Let's move it!
Oh, Jesus! Please, just let me live.
This is the Ville. It doesn't take a friggin' Einstein to figure out that this place is probably hostile. Flush and frag, ladies. I want every hooch searched and cleared.
Glad you're the Einstein.
Watch your fire around the villagers. Move out.
What a staggered column right now. Not like one grenade to kill us all.
Haha, looks like Walter Cronkite just shit himself. Hey, I hope you got that on film.
shit! Booby trap!
Oh, God. Donald, did you get that? Tell me you got that.
I got it. Great stuff.
Cease fire, goddammit! Cool it! We gotta move on. Keep your eyes on the path. It's probably rigged with 100 traps.
What about Hayes? We can't just leave him.
We'll come back for him after we're done. I hate it as much as you, but we gotta clear the Ville. We won't leave him behind. Now let's haul ass.
Those fuckers gonna pay for what they did to Hayes, man. I shit you not.
Chill out, Smooth. There are gonna be a lot of friendlies in there who had nothing to do with this. Keep your head on straight.
Huh? Just walk through the trap, ever so casually.
We're not VZ! GI number one!
Dong Yan! Just stay put, Papa San! Keep your hands
GI
right
number
and
one,
see him.
Please! Do not kill us, please!
Hold your fire! It's just a mama-san!
She's a friendly! Stand down!
Horseshit, man! This place is Charlieville!
Hey, cool it! Sting every villager, you wind up creating a lot more VC! Namsung! Don't lie! Don't lie!
Y'all something bad! Sending a
bantai! Y'all! Motherfucker! That's what I'm talking about! That's how we handle this shit!
Dear Mr. and Mrs. Roland Shepard, this is...
It's happening too often.
keep getting shot, don't I? Of a pistol.
he'll hurt me.
Everyone okay? Anyone hurt? Where's that candy-ass reporter? Get over here, grunts! We gotta locate this glory hound reporter and his fat-ass sidekick. Spread out and find him. Now look alive!
Great. Idiots. Come on. Horseshit. Alright, with that, I'm coming up on an hour. I'm going to leave it there. I'll play a bit more another
day. Dear Mr. and Mrs. Roland Shepard,
I do miss this game.
This is one of the most difficult letters I have been required to write.
I'm enjoying playing it again.
It is with the most heartfelt sympathy that I, as his commanding officer, write to you at the death of
his son. Hopefully you guys enjoy it, and we'll give it a look-see. It was a fun game when I played it as a child. It still holds up to what it was. Anyway, thank you for joining. We'll chat to you again.